Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the SyncFusion React Charts axes. I will also explain how to display a axis title, multiple axes, and an inversed axis, as well as how to set axis crossing, an opposed position, tick lines, and grid lines. Let's start with the coding part. I will open my existing application, which already has the SyncFusion React Charts package installed. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic chart rendering code. If you want to learn how to create a basic React chart, please refer to my Getting Started video link in the card above or in the description below. With this chart code, you can visualize weather forecast data in a column series. Let me run the application to show the chart. Look at the chart. The data is plotted as a column series. Let me show you how to add a title to the chart axis. I include the title option in the primary x-axis property and set its value to days of the week. Then, I include the primary y-axis property and set its title to temperature. I will also customize the axis label value by including the label format option and adding f after the axis label value. Check now and titles are added to the chart's x and y-axis. The custom label format is also applied to the y-axis. Now I will show you how to customize the width and color of the tick and grid lines. You can do this using the options major grid lines, minor grid lines, major tick lines, and minor tick lines. I include the major grid lines option in the primary x-axis property and set the color to green and width to 1. Then, I include the major tick lines option and set the color to red and width to 2. Then, copy and paste the same options into the primary y-axis property. Checking the chart now, the grid and tick lines are customized with the specified colors and widths. There is also an option to render the axis at the opposite of its default side. To do so, I include the opposed position option in primary y-axis property and set its value to true. Now, the y-axis is rendered opposite from its default side. Notice here, the axis values always start with the lowest value and end with the highest. You can change this order by using the isInversed option. I include this option in the primary y-axis property and set its value to true. See now, the chart y-axis order is changed to highest value first and lowest value last. Next, I'm going to show you how to set multiple series in the chart. Before doing that, I will remove the grid and tick line customization along with the isInversed and opposed position options. I'm going to render a line series, so I import it from SyncFusion React Charts package and inject it into the chart services. I include another series directive and set its type to line. I bind the same chart data here and set the name to Japan. I then bind the day field to the XName option and the value 1 field to the YName option. I will also enable marker visibility. Look here, the chart is rendered with two series. Japanese weather report is shown in the line series. Now let's see how to add another axis in the chart. In addition to the X and Y axes, we can add n number of axes to the chart. To add multiple axes, I import the axes directive module from the SyncFusion React Charts package and include the axes directive tag. I add a single axis directive tag and set its name to Y-axis1. I map this name to the Y-axis name property in series 2. Then I enable the opposed position option to show the axis values on the opposite side of the y-axis. I also add the label format option to display the values in Celsius. See now, the chart shows the temperature in Celsius on one axis and Fahrenheit on another axis. Finally, I will show you how to position the axis in the chart using crosses at and crosses in axis properties. The crosses at option specifies values where the axis lines should intersect. I include the crosses at option in the primary x-axis property and set its value to 30. Then I set the crosses at value to 2 in the primary y-axis property. Look here, the X and Y axes cross at the points 30 and 2. You can also choose the name of the axis that will be intersected. By default, the primary X and Y axes will intersect. Now I include the crosses in axis property and map the name of the newly added axis. As you can see, the primary X axis crossed at points 2 and 30 with the newly added axis. Let me quickly summarize what we have seen in this video. I showed you how to customize the SyncFusion React Charts axes. We saw how to display a title, multiple axes, and an inversed axis, and how to set axis crossing, an opposed position, tick lines, and grid lines. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.